Hey, this is Solid Snake, and you're listening to Droids Canada. So, pay some damn attention.
This is David Faustino.
Hello, this is Andrew Chalmers, the writer and doctor in Doctor Who, Doctor.
This is Dr. Steve-o.
Everybody, this is the Governator.
This is Inspector Gadget.
Hey, what's cracking, y'all? It's your boy, J-Rock.
Good evening, folks. This is James Duval.
This is Jeremy Taggart.
This is Kim Percival.
I'm Chris Holden-Reed.
Hey, this is Pat Mastriani from Degrassi.
This is the evil Dr. Badvise.
Again, this is Messy Bear. And this is Wolf from X-Men.
Hey, this is Andrew Gazzess.
This is Sean Gunn.
Hi, this is Robert Carradine.
It's Tammy Stronach from The NeverEnding Story.
Hey, it's Zach Callison.
Hey, I'm DJ Jenny Rock.
And I'm Neil Young.
I'm Commander Shepard.
Ralph Garman here. You're listening to Droids Canada. You've made an excellent choice. You have chosen wisely.
Warning. Listener discretion is advised.
That means there's a lot of fucking swearing.
Hello.
That's ready to burn, so get those stakes up higher. There's a thousand pretty women waiting out there. They're all living the devil may care, and I am just a devil with no spare. So
Viva Las Vegas! Viva Las Vegas!
How I wish that there were more than 24 hours in the day. Even if there were 40 more, I wouldn't sleep a minute away.
Oh, oh.
Is this on?
iTunes.
Hey, buddy, how you doing?
Not bad. What's going on?
Boob sweat. I had a little bit going earlier, but I kind of reduced down to an A cup.
I kept it minty, so I'm good.
You kept it...
Keep it minty.
What do you mean, minty?
What's that?
Like,
no.
Do you put, like... Are you one of those guys that take, like, the car spearmint thing and you rub it all over yourself so you stay fresh?
What the fuck is that?
I knew a guy who once violated an air sponge.
Like, to smell like Christmas tree?
I mean...
Like, where?
So, the guy in question, I will remain nameless... was running late for work, and he didn't have enough time to take a shower, which realistically...
So what about the Italian shower? Why don't you just take the Italian shower?
What's the Italian shower?
Wet your hair and put on cologne.
Oh, God, so true. Shittily! No, so he looked over, he's like, I can take a shower, and there's the air sponge. Mine gets my business in the corner.
Shit.
So... Mathematically speaking, it probably would have took him a good 15 minutes to break apart said air sponge and rub it all over himself. Or
why would you break it apart?
Let me finish. And then, or taking a shower. So then I see him later that day, and I see this blue stuff sticking out from underneath his shirt. Oh, what's that? He just looked at me and goes, I mean, you wouldn't believe it.
So
then I get a phone call from my friend saying, is so-and-so there? I'm like, yeah. He violated my fucking air sponge because it's missing and there's crumples of it all over the place. Oh my God, it's funny. There's some blue shit on his arm. Oh my God, we get to hear it again.
There you go. Hey, the entire show.
Is there like a one-hour version?
Do an hour loop.
So why are we talking about Las Vegas?
Because you're going to Las Vegas. And this will be your first Las Vegas experience.
It is.
Okay, do you have it on a one-hour loop?
There is no one-hour loop. You know how depressing that is? There's a remix.
Or is it depressing you'd want to hear it?
Are you rolling? Can I record? Can I do this?
Of course you want to hear it.
Hold on. Fun. Sounds weird.
There you go. So...
Are you using the fucking sirens a part of this? That's a cab. Okay. Rippers!
So,
I don't understand why we're... that's the MGM Grand. Keep note where we are. That's the MGM Grand. We're going to go there.
Okay, and where are you staying?
Excalibur.
Okay. It's diagonal to it.
And you know what's funny? We're like, oh, we're going to take a cab from the airport.
No.
It's around the corner.
No.
It is around the corner.
You need transportation from it.
It's 7 minutes on foot.
Okay.
No. Did I say 7 minutes
on foot? Have you been there? Have you been there?
No.
Number of times.
I mean...
with my mother.
I hope I don't get stuck in a sex show with my mother.
I've been with my wife as well.
That happened to a friend of mine who went to Vegas. They went to like a Cirque du Soleil, didn't really read up on which one it was. And his mom's like, you want to go? He said, sure. Next thing he knows, he's in a Cirque du Soleil live sex show with her.
So I saw...
best date ever, 2.5 stars.
I saw Carmen Electra's boobs.
So jealous.
Well, we were staying at the MGM. And we were comped the Crazy Horse, the Carmen Electra Crazy Horse show,
which is
burlesque.
Oh, okay.
It was a burlesque show.
I'm just trying to keep this clean.
So where are seats where we were like very, very close to the stage, like from Meteor, Wall of Shame away from the stage, and all it was people marching around with their boobs out, and it was like teenage boy giddy. We were just laughing the whole time. And at one point we're like, hey, this like I've seen enough boobs. Let's leave. So we're like, well, it's going to be rude to just kind of get up and walk out while they're doing their thing. And we're like the first person they see. And then I was just like, fuck it. Got up, gave a little wave, and out I went.
When I was in Mexico with my dad, he was counting boobs. He would update me on
it. He would count the boobs? Her dad is quite the rock star, by the way. He helped me today. He saved my life today. He did. He brought me my box spring.
Oh.
So we assembled this bed. I got really excited about it. Okay, listen, this is an AB conversation, okay? This is very important to me right now.
Have you ever done this kind of thing before?
Have you ever done this thing?
There you go.
It's the entire album of Wham.
This is the song they played with the... gasoline fight from Zoolander.
I trolled
Orange Mocha Frappuccinos.
I trolled AJ pretty hard today.
What'd you
at the hockey game?
Uh oh.
Dr. Jones, where are ya? Fucking drop some aqua. And then of course for you, the Italian fight song was played at the end of the game. Good old glory days.
Did they win?
No, we lost horribly. 6-3 is the last game of the season, and I fist pump for you.
But do they have the Zamboni driver in net for him?
I mean, my name is not the Toronto Maple Leafs, but I'm sure I'm embarrassed as fuck.
Because that is...
I live pretty close to that. And
that is quite a story.
And the worst part is, wasn't he a Toronto Marlies goalie?
No. He's a practice goalie for the Toronto Marlies, but also the guy who drives the Zamboni in there.
Isn't that kind of really, like, wouldn't you...
Every game, there's an emergency goaltender, just in case.
Wouldn't you brand him as a traitor?
No, he was listed as the emergency goaltender.
Rachel!
Every game has one emergency goaltender who's in the crowd at the game. So if one team has two goaltenders injured,
they
bring in the emergency goaltender.
Oh.
This guy got in and actually got the win against the high fire-powered Toronto Maple Leafs.
And they lost 6-3?
No, I am actually a Leaf fan.
Yeah, he knows all about pain. He's been a Leaf fan since he's been alive, so he knows about disappointment and pain.
Yeah, but you like the freaking Habs.
At least my
side
team.
By each.
Side by each. Bah ouais.
I put the puck. You know why it has the CH? You know why the CH is there?
What?
So they know where to drop the puck. At center heist.
Oh, wish Mark was here to defend us. You know, he wants to come out on the show one day, so maybe you guys should have a witty banter.
Witty banter about how the Habs suck?
Side by each.
By gar. There were my boots gone.
What the fuck?
That's what French people
say. Jacques Cousteau.
That was a lucro bataille.
Fucking goon. She doesn't know anything we're talking about right now. She's just listening to Jitterbug.
Just listening to Jitterbug.
Jitterbug. Is that a sex move? We should look that up in a dictionary. The Jitterbug.
Jitterbug? Look it up.
I don't know. My phone's in the other room. I'm not prepared.
All right.
Hold on. I'll go to the internet.
Hold on. I'm going
to
pull you. Buy me some time.
But, I mean, they have black lights on in this music video that no one can watch.
What else is that black light going to pick up?
What's on her face? Why is it so potent and thick? Boo. Boo. Bukkake. That's a Bukkake party. I'm sure those existed in the 60s, 70s, 80s, and 90s. I mean, if you want to have a giant jug of the white, like, stuff on you, or the very thick man butter. Hey, remember the time you watched Ted 2? Yeah, when he dropped the entire thing of semen on himself? Yeah, that was kind of hot. I don't know if he's laughing at us or what he just read.
So, there's a number of jitterbugs on the Urban Dictionary.
Oh, okay.
Some of them just dealing with dance.
I don't know.
One of them, like a noun for the good old state of Florida. It's like an immature person or a young person. The shittiest phone in the world is the jitterbug. Never heard of it. But this is the one that I like. When someone grabs their nuts in their hand and shakes it vigorously in front of a large group of people, jitterbugging is often done as a group event. That is, I'm just reading.
Don't shoot the messenger.
Just reading.
That's pretty bad, though. I mean,
all right. Let's see. Wow, there's a lot in here.
I mean, if there's a bad word in it, can you just, not say the word? Oh, no. My screen died.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no.
We're going to be stuck on Foreigner for the rest of the time now?
We might be because I don't know if my order.
Oh, no.
I saw it blink.
Buy me some time. Buy me some time. We're supposed to be talking about freaking Vegas.
Okay, talk about Vegas because I'm trying to fix my
monitor. All right. It's where they had the... Oh, there we go.
I'm bleeping it all out anyways because you've... So, now I gotta come back through and fucking bleed out fucking...
I was reading something, so it wasn't me, it wasn't you. It was...
Social justice warriors.
It is the fault of Urban Dictionary.
We will end up at CNN.
Well, there's a good chance of that. No, they're too busy bashing Trump.
Anyways, back to Vegas.
So, you're...
I'm just going to keep hammering it out at this point, because I have to come back through and clear through anyways.
Okay, so...
Have you seen my fucking khakis, you fucking...
You can't walk from the airport to the strip. You can't.
Hold on, wait.
Okay.
Relates to this.
Okay, I will show you how you can get to the hotel.
See how I put that in there? I purposely did that.
So... what you do is once you get out of the airport and you get to the street, there's a ton of different transportation companies that are there.
Pause.
What you do... No, not pausing. What you do... Because we'll get off topic and talk about something else.
Oh, so that's just a street meet there.
What you do is... there's not. Why the fuck would there be street meet there?
I know, I'm canceling.
So what you do is you go to one of these places. They're advertised all over it.
Are they...
And what you do is it costs you like $20.
Okay.
And they give you... a token to get to your hotel and to get back. So what you do is you also have a number. My flight leaves here. Okay, we will be picking up at Excalibur at 3 p.m. Okay, and then you jump on the shuttle and they bring you back. This way you have a way back to the airport if you've lost all your money.
That's fucking smart.
Yes, it is.
Cocksucker.
Number two.
Oh, there's... there's more.
When you are in Vegas.
I'm listening.
Keep your credit card in an RFID-protected wallet.
I have one.
Excellent. Because people can bump into you and tap your info. Well, nerd alert. So, now, when you're at Excalibur, okay, you need to go to Dick's Last Resort. Dick's Last Resort.
Why are we going to Richard's house?
You're going to Dick's Last Resort.
Okay.
Dick's Last Resort is an anti-restaurant. It's a restaurant where they just rip the shit out of everyone.
Oh, I see
yes.
that one. Did I say you called and said hi?
Walked up to the hostess stand. They looked at me and go, "What the fuck do you want?" And I'm like, "I love this place. Love it."
What if I told them to talk dirty to me and spit in my ass?
There was a table of a bachelorette party.
Oh.
The server came and put a hat on the bride that said, "I'm the biggest whore in Las Vegas and suck dick for wooden nickels."
AJ would be he's blushing. He hasn't even heard this episode. He's blushing.
That's this kind of place. And
AJ
it's a fun place.
But he's got the biggest bag of wooden nickels I've ever seen.
Now,
don't ask how he got them.
This is a rule to have in Vegas.
Okay. Stay on the strip, I heard.
Yeah, you can go to Fremont and stuff, though, but...
I was told
what you gotta do is you gotta get a pass, a day pass for the Deuce.
I'm sorry? The Deuce?
The Deuce. The Deuce is a double-decker bus that goes from one end of the strip all the way to the outlet mall past Fremont.
I thought I'm gonna take a shit.
So anywhere you need to get... Huge. Huge. So anywhere you need to get where you'd want to go, you can get on via the Deuce.
So is that something you buy daily?
Yeah.
Now, how much is that?
I can't remember. Last time I was there was years ago.
Okay.
So, now, you want to go to Treasure Island and you want to get the baked potato at the coffee shop there?
You know what? We should make notes. Make notes. Make notes.
Do you like Chinese food?
I have dabbled in the Asian cuisine.
Okay. Next to Treasure Island, there's the Fashion Mall. It's called the Fashion Mall. They have a food court that has a golden panda. And the Chinese food there is freaking incredible. And carrying my wayward son. Jesus.
This is the only reason why Supernatural's lasted this long, because this song is glorious.
Okay, then after this, can I make one song request?
Is that actually people going to know it?
Peter Frampton? Do you feel like we do? Live version.
Wow.
One of the greatest guitar solos ever.
Like, shunned you down with her face. She said, bitch, please, with her face.
Bitch, please.
Bye, Felicity. Or is it by Felicia? I don't know.
Is it Felicia? Now, will you be, with the exception of the certain tickets that you told me you had, how many days are you there?
Technically 5 days, 4 nights.
Oh, Jesus.
Well, because...
You're going to be technical.
Well, no, it's because the day we fly back, our flight's at 11 o'clock at night, and we check out at 11.
There you go.
So we literally have to find something to do for 10 hours. I was thinking about just... I was thinking about being a part of a police officer, like the prostitute ring. It'd be fun.
If you
just lure them out with candy.
If you have a thick wallet, you can go to the gun store. The gun store.
Did you get your tickets?
For?
The gun show.
You just kissed your arm.
So, now I kissed my muscle.
You almost knocked over your coffee doing it in the process. So... there's a place called the Gun Store where you can shoot any gun they have.
That's what she said. It's funny you say
that. You pay for the ammo, and machine guns, you name it, you can shoot the fuck out of stuff.
Go on.
So, that's kind of neat.
Go on.
Now, are you going to any shows? Any shows?
Well, as we discussed,
yes,
we are going, because that weekend before... Mm-hmm. Is AEW's Double or Nothing, their big pay-per-view of the year.
Yeah.
Their WrestleMania. Mm-hmm. And I didn't know that, and we booked the wrong week.
Or all AEW shows out of Vegas?
No.
Okay.
So they're doing, it's kind of like what WWE does. They'll do their big show, like one of the big fours, and then they'll do...
The Raw and SmackDown thereafter.
So that's what they're doing there.
Okay.
So they're doing the MGM Grand for Double or Nothing, and then Wednesday they're going back to do their Wednesday show.
Okay.
I'm going to be on TV, Dan.
You have Wednesday show,
too. Lieutenant Dan, I'm going to be on TV.
Do you want more Vegas info?
I'm listening. I mean, I didn't stop talking.
If you're going to be going to any show, any Vegas-style show, I highly recommend them because they're awesome.
I want to go to a good Cirque du Soleil, but not like one I actually would want
to
see.
Go to the Beatles one at Mirage.
I checked. It's not there.
It's not there anymore?
Beatles left. I looked. The only one I've seen there was like the Elvis one.
Is O there?
The Donut Smile?
Okay. Buy me some time.
Hey, remember the time we talked about cake farts?
Cake farts.
I listened to that episode the other day. Dan hates cellophane.
Because it's stupid.
You know what? This proves one thing. You don't even listen to our podcast because I downloaded that episode specifically on your phone. It was the middle of the night. There's always excuses with you.
Because cellophane's stupid. All it does is sticks to your hands. It's loud. Yes. I got warm hands.
Wow, Dan's taking forever. Shout out to Big Mike.
Big Mike!
And, David?
Nope.
Wait a minute. That feels like controversy.
Okay, The Beatles Love by Cirque du Soleil. Yes, it is still at the Mirage.
How much does he think a ticket is?
$79. For Vegas shows? Not whatsoever. But, this is what you do.
Is there a shit seat?
No.
What do you mean? I mean,
here's...
I'm not going to a live sex show.
You can get those. There's a same day ticket sale booth, like a 2-for-1 discount ticket booth. You don't get any tickets, you get them there. Because then you can get a lot less.
So you're saying I gotta find them. I gotta find the wizard of the discounted tickets.
Yes.
His name is Gandalf.
Here's the other thing.
I was there.
Do you have 2 hours to kill?
I mean, I have what? Now?
No.
There?
When you're there.
I'm gonna have 5 days to kill.
So, okay, there are places everywhere that are going to try to get you to sign up to do their little tour for the timeshare.
Oh, no.
The timeshare. Yes.
And then we'll be stuck on selloffvacations.com and end up in Sandals, Jamaica?
We did one of these timeshare things just to see what it was all about. Because it was fucking hilarious. We told them we made like $250,000 a year. And so we're like, so I just kept on giving them the old like, no, it's not worth my time to go and even look at this. So they kept on upping the stuff they were going to give me.
I broke my
show tickets, free dinner, and $200 Visa gift card.
That?
To go to this meeting, which was a high-pressure sales meeting. At one point, I asked for a piece of paper so I could crunch some numbers. No, all I did was wrote the word no on the piece of paper and stopped talking and just started tapping the word no with a pen. It worked.
It's like that episode of
it worked exceptionally well.
When they learned Morse code to talk to each other.
Thank you. Great song.
I mean, you don't normally listen to good music, so this is a one-off.
What the fuck are you talking about?
Hey, man, remember the time that we're like, we can't afford concert tickets. Times are tough right now. Pearl Jam. Oh, times are ton. Now I'm going to Foo Fighters.
Oh, fighting Foos.
I'm going to Rage Against Machine. I'm going to Disturbed. I'm going to Stained.
Stained. They suck.
Well, it's a part of the Disturbed show. I mean, whatever.
So.
And then she wants to go to other shows. And then on top of it, I'm trying to be a dickhead to AJ.
Why?
One of his favorite bands is in town, and I've been picking at him.
What is the band?
Apocalyptica. But that's not the band that he wants to see the most. Lacuna Coil is playing with them.
Oh, fuck.
He is stupid for Lacuna Coil. I don't get him.
That group likes that.
So all day I sent him gifts saying, do it. I said, buy 3 tickets, we'll go. And I'm like, do it. Just. I had the Shia LaBeoufs out, like, don't let your dreams be dreams. Do it!
I got my brother really mad at me because of Lacuna Coil.
Okay.
Well, him and that group of people that all like that band.
Okay, so the band sucks, but well, you can't say that.
They fucking suck. He was saying about how good they are and how popular they are in the world and how awesome they are. I'm like, then why the fuck hasn't anyone heard of them?
They had their one song in Guitar Hero 2, I think.
Oh, fuck it.
I mean, that's big.
They suck.
I have a friend that's going to be on. I don't want to say who it is. I have a friend who has a very popular band who is going to be on the NHL 2021 soundtrack potentially.
Yeah, I know that.
No, I told you that.
What's that?
Oh.
Well, no, I know what the band. I know what the band is.
I just fucking ruined everything.
You didn't ruin anything because I didn't say it.
I'm gonna fucking.
I didn't say it.
Okay, calm down. Calm your tits.
We always get along.
Calm.
We always get along.
Tits.
Have we ever gotten in a fight?
No, we've been snippy to each other.
We've been snippy.
And it happens every single time at a Comic Con.
Yeah.
Because one of us gets extremely stressed out and the other one's trying to put out the fire. We have to have the snap. The snap has to happen. And then the other guy goes, okay, does the jazz hand, walks away, comes back 10 minutes later, the other guy's like, I'm sorry, I was stressed out. It's true, it does happen.
Right.
The first time I saw him stressed out...
I put out fires, that's what I do.
No, the time I saw you stressed out is when you were trying to get over your fears of zombies.
Yeah, I left.
Yeah, you fucking left me there. No, see, didn't I show you that video? Yeah, he was missing for half an hour.
But I went then to the toy section.
You know what? I was really pissed off at him, but I forgave him because he got me a flaming Moe. That was like one of the best energy drinks I've ever had.
They're horrible. But it hits the spot when... It hits the spot.
It's a spot.
Because there's stages of Todd.
Yeah. When it comes down to Comic-Cons?
Yes.
She wants to dress up at a Comic-Con.
Stages.
She wants to dress up as Lady Death. Like what's her face does.
Lady Death. Like Meg.
Is that her name now? Yeah, Meg. Yeah. She spells it really weird.
Mm.
Yeah. M-A. Yeah. She's not going to Comic-Cons no more, I don't think.
No?
No.
Holy fuck.
Oh, that's 5 minutes we're losing.
Jesus Christ.
You know what? I'm going to save the original cut of this. No!
I got to... Literally, dude, I got to... It's like I have a can of lighter fluid in my hand. Let's fucking light this shit up.
I think we should wrap up this episode because I have another topic that's going to be good for your kind of fuel right now.
Good times.
But I don't want to waste on this episode.
Oh.
I want
to. So you'll have to tune in next time.
You were being a dick. You were being. Hey, what's a regular coffee, Dan?
It's one cream and one sugar.
Fuck you, Dan. Yeah, it was.
There wasn't a problem. I just didn't know what it was.
It's always a woman. First, it was Miss Elizabeth.
Like I said,
broke up the mega powers with Hulk Hogan and Macho Man Randy Savage, and then she showed up, and she's like, "Well, I want a fucking regular coffee," and now there's fucking conflict.
What the fuck are you drinking there, Yoko?
Oh, you're the reason why John Lennon got shot. No,
that was the guy in the dog.
No, he was aiming for Yoko.
Yoko.
Oh no.
Right.
I guess you could just say bye-bye and we just stop, because I have to edit this fucking horrific podcast now.
Don't edit it.
I have to edit
Uncut.
It.
Uncut.
No.
Don't edit it.
Dan, it's pretty bad when I'm the one that's pulling the reins.
You don't have to. You don't have to.
Dan, I have
don't
to
Don't be afraid.
Dan, I have
don't
to be
Don't be afraid. Anyone who's possibly listening to us right now, do you want this episode edited?
Yeah.
After the fact? So, no.
You know what? We should just... do a Patreon and have people pay us to hear her actually.
Uncut.
And this episode's being cut. Sorry, buddy.
No, it's not.
I can't. No. Good contents let you have your own. Like, if you want, you know what? Do your own YouTube video on your own Facebook and then we'll go on.
His guitar's talking.
Is it actually talking though?
Or
is
it does. Guy,
or is it, it's not T-Pain in the background with a vocoder?
It's not T-Pain. This is like 1970s. This was when...
I'm on a boat!
This was pre-Pain.
I'm on a boat! Wow. You know, there's no such thing as talent anymore. It's just vocoders.
Vocoders?
Ask the Biebs.
Oh, the Biebs.
Looks like a roofer. Looks like a roofer.
Wait, it's talking.
He's reaching new heights. Okay.
That was a good roofer comment on that. Sorry. Bye-bye.